Good morning, students. Welcome to the online class of Premium Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today, we are going to start a new chapter in English grammar book. The name of the chapter is Conjunctions. Okay, we'll go through the definitions. We'll understand what is conjunctions. We'll go through the examples to tell you in the best possible way. Okay, conjunctions join words, phrases, or clauses. The different types of conjunctions indicate different relationship between the elements. Now, here we get to know that conjunctions are the joining words. The words that join other words, phrases or clauses. And different conjunctions tells us about the different relationships between the elements joined. Here elements are words, phrases or clauses, whatever is applicable. Okay. So, according to this, we'll go through the types of conjunctions. First one is coordinating, second is correlative, and the third one is subordinating. Coordinating conjunctions link elements of equal value, coordinate. Okay, they coordinate. Okay, so they add the elements, they link the elements of equal value. Correlative are used in pairs to establish a specific relationship between elements of equal value. And subordinating conjunctions indicate that one element is of lesser value to another element. Okay. You will get through these things better in a better way when I start using the examples. We will start with this. Using coordinating conjunctions to connect elements of equal grammatical value, that is swimming and reading, both of these are of equal values. Swimming and reading are my two favorite summer activities. Here swimming and reading are connected, they are linked with the conjunction that is and. Okay. Please place the papers on the top of the desk or in the drawer. Now, desk and drawer. These two are the elements joined with or. Both are same. She wanted to drive the car, but she had never received her license. Okay. She wanted to drive the car and she had never received her license are both independent clauses. These both are clauses that are joined by but. Okay. And now, let me tell you, 7 coordinating conjunctions are there in English grammar, that is, for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. So, that is your coordinating conjunction, okay. Moving on to the next part, that is correlative. Correlative, you may have seen neither, nor, either, or, whether, or, not only, but also, both, and, as. So, they basically, these are the conjunctions that are, there are at least 2 conjunctions in the same sentence. Okay, you must decide either to fly or to drive, either or. These are your correlative conjunctions. Contrary to my plans, I spent much of my vacation both collecting papers and contacting students. Both and these both, there are 2 conjunctions in correlative conjunctions. Okay, I hope not only that you will attend the play, but also that you will stay for the cast party afterwards. So these are also the 2 correlative conjunctions. Okay. Moving on to the next one, using subordinating conjunctions. These are some common subordinating conjunctions that are after, even though, then, whenever, that, where, if, although, as, in order, that, though, whereas. I'll give you some examples. Subordinating conjunction indicates that the dependent clause is not complete without an attached independent clause. As the name suggests in the clause you have read, dependent clause is not complete without independent clause. Got it? You will understand it in a better way with the help of example. If you finish your homework, you will be prepared for the test. Okay. You finish your homework and you will be prepared for the test. If you finish your homework, by itself is an incomplete thought. If you finish your homework, it is incomplete. We need to complete it with you will be prepared for the test. I lose myself in the music whenever I practice the piano. This one is incomplete. Whenever I practice the piano, and this one is complete. I lose myself in the music. Okay. So, dependent with independent, dependent with independent. Okay, subordinate joins these. Now going for conjunctive adverbs, sometimes called adverbial conjunctions. These are however, therefore, moreover, nevertheless. Okay, common conjunctive adverbs these are. For example, carrot cake is very tasty. Moreover, the carrots make it a healthy choice for dessert. Okay. Basically, when conjunctive adverb appears at the beginning or in the middle of independent clause, it is usually set up by commas. Commas, moreover, has a comma after this one. When a conjunctive adverb introduces a second clause within a sentence, a semicolon precedes it and a comma follows it. Okay, I realize you were busy. It is unfortunate, however, that you missed that phone call. The hurricane has lessened its intensity. Nevertheless, we are evacuating in an hour. Okay, now study this. Although he works hard, he does not earn much. And I like tea and coffee. As I came, she left the room. Because she sold her car because it was very old. But he reads newspapers, but he doesn't like to read magazines. Either, I'm sorry, my mother is ill and I can't come either. Even, she likes swimming even in winter. Even if, always wear seatbelt even in the, if the rod is empty. How? Do you know how to thread a needle? However, we have lost the match. If they arrived on time, they could go to the party. He looks very fit in spite of his age. Neither. They didn't go to the party and neither did I. Or, do you like tea or coffee? Otherwise, use GPS directions, otherwise you'll get lost. Since he's lost his money, he couldn't go to the restaurant. Unless, her baby can't fall asleep unless she stays in the room. What? I don't know what to say. When you are in London, do pay a visit to us. Whether I'm going home, whether you like it or not. So students, that's it. We got through a lot of examples. Now you will be able to understand the conjunctions in a better way. I hope so. So before leaving, like the video, subscribe to our channel, share the video. I promise you to meet in the next video. Till then, take care, have a nice day, thank you.